First, we have been very clear what is the cost of trade war. By next year, we would lose, as a planet, $700 billion. This is 0.8% of the global GDP. Everybody loses. Second, we have been also very clear what can be done so this slowdown in a synchronized manner we have seen can be stopped and reversed. And we say to countries three things. One, if you have monetary space, if you can cut interest rates, please do it. Very few countries now have that much space. Two, if you have fiscal space, please use it. Some countries do have fiscal space, and we are seeing even more reluctant players like Germany, the Netherlands, South Korea. They're coming up with stimulus packages. Three, most important, everybody can do it. Structural reforms, labor market reforms, eliminate red tape so private sector can boom, jobs can be created. So one, two, three, and I think we see governments around the world actually listening.
But a lot of countries don't have fiscal room to take out more tools out of the monetary policy box. That's the big problem, and the world is very leveraged right now. If you see a further slowdown or this trade war continuing, is the IMF ready to step in? Do you guys have enough resources to do that?
And that was the very good news that we got during our annual meetings in October, my inaugural. Our shareholders committed to provide the IMF with financial capacity of $1 trillion. So we do have sufficient firing power to step up. But we tell countries, do the right thing, so you don't need to come and knock on our door for money.
Right now, at this moment, how are you feeling about all the uncertainties? Do you feel optimistic that we're going to work as a global team? Because that's the message that you've been giving everyone.
What we see is that we need each other more, but it is harder and harder to come together. And institutions like the IMF have a duty to bring our 189 membership and seek that consensus to take action together when this is necessary. I do believe that the world is changing much more rapidly today than 10, 20, 30 years ago. This is the new normal. Uncertainty is the new normal. And therefore, we have to help our membership to be more agile, more adaptable to this fast-changing world. Enjoy the pace of change today. It will never be that slow in the future.